what's interesting is homeopathy seems to work for those who, I guess, I don't know if it's the principle that it will work for everybody, or it's your faith in that method.
There is something to it, but it isn't really understood. One of the new newsletters I'm getting on health has a one-page article on it, and the person who wrote the article says she personally doubts it. She thinks it's a placebo effect, and she thinks that the studies were just not adequately done, even though she has to admit they got positive results on a lot of studies.
On homeopathic?
Homeopathic, yeah, but she still doesn't accept it. She's a traditional MD. But they have gotten results with homeopathic research.
Have you used it?
It's not worked for me.
It hasn't?
I tried it just once. I was in Belgium to lecture, and I had a bad cold, and they gave me homeopathic, and it didn't do a thing. But I only get colds when I'm frustrated and not dealing with it.
Sometimes it gets a little longer.
Yeah, well, it...
Well, colds also, it's more complex. It may involve some other remedy. Whereas like a more or less universal one, like arnica for like blows and contusions,
mm-hmm.
you know, if you use that, then it would seem like that would be more consistent.
Yeah, that's the only time I ever tried it.
Yeah. What do you use for healing?
I use my subconscious.
Oh, okay. You don't use herbs or...
No. Well, I just get minor symptoms, and when I get a minor symptom, I talk to my subconscious. I say, all right, what's your problem? Let's do something about it. It clears up.
And you get the answer right away?
No, I don't always figure it out consciously, but it clears up. Whatever it is, it fixes itself.
What about nothing major or
no,
serious?
The last time I had medical help, other than delivering four kids, was early 1945. Over 50 years ago.
Oh. No back problems or like that's chronic.
Minor little bitty backache when I don't exercise enough to strengthen the back muscles. And
I think the
body heals
you.
Itself if you're working with your subconscious and if you like yourself in your life.
Mm-hmm. I believe that. I always believe that.
That's true.
Because there's not that many people who look at it like that in the world. Therefore, you have to fight people sometimes because they have this tremendous awe of the medical field,
mm-hmm.
which, you know, is the Wild West. There's
mm-hmm.
nothing proven in most places. We're still experimenting. In the case of my father, they got him to the hospital. They said, well, there's these blockbuster drugs that can really break up that clot. We're going to send him to Allegheny General, which is a hospital renowned in all sorts of areas, especially
mm-hmm.
neurological.
Mm-hmm.
They get him down there, and the doctor there, who was a specialist, the one in the other hospital wasn't,
mm-hmm.
says, well, we only have a 3-hour window, not a 6, and because of his physical condition, his heart condition,
mm-hmm.
he had arthritis, he was overweight,
mm-hmm.
all these symptoms, all these factors, we can't use the drug, it might kill him.
Mm-hmm.
Well, they don't know, there's nothing very certain sure.
No, there's nothing final, where human beings are concerned. They're just too complex. Medicine really is an art, like astrology and psychology.
Yes.
It's an art. It's not a science, because humans are just too complicated. And
animals, too.
And animals. Life is too complicated. But I like Goffman's description. He called all of these subjects the tinkering trades. You try this. Oh, didn't work. Try this. Oh, that didn't work either. Try this.
Oh. So if herbs don't work, try homeopathy.
Right.
Homeopathy doesn't work,
try
sleep therapy.
Well,
yeah,
or
hypnosis.
Well,
yeah.
In India, they do both Ayurvedic or
yeah.
Yeah,
and I have absolutely no faith in Ayurvedic because it's so simplistic when you get three types, of people and the diet they prescribe, it totally alienates me and turns me off.
Bach flowers?
No, I have no faith in that either. I do think there's something in homeopathy, however,
yes.
because they have done research with it, and they've gotten statistical results. That the studies that they felt were the better studies, they did studies with people taking placebos. They were double-blind studies, and the people getting the homeopathy remedy, twice as many got better as placebo, as the people the control group. So there's something going on there. It's not fake, but it's something very subtle, and it doesn't work for everybody, or it doesn't work for all conditions. It's an off again, on again possibility. But all that the homeopathy people can do to explain it is that the water has some kind of memory because they actually dilute the original substance to such a point that some quantity of the homeopathic thing has nothing left of this. It's totally missing, gone, but the supposedly the water has a memory of this original substance that was included in it, yes, from shaking it, and it's because the shaking, this percussion, that is supposed to imprint it on the water, and so it doesn't make any sense to the materialists. They can't explain it.
Well, there's don't they say that basically it's the subtle body or the astral body that's being affected?
Yeah, that's the thing.
It's not just a
physical effect anymore. There's no detectable amount of the original healing, supposedly healing property left in the water when it's diluted to that extent.